Radios, GPS systems, and even some TV shows are all ran off satellites. But what if someone could take down this technology with the push of a button? Since the 1950s, anti-satellite technology, or ASAT, has gone different places. Countries like the USA choose to stick with simple tech that hasn't changed much since its inception. But India has joined the club and has made NASA furious. It was March 27th when the missile was launched, fired at a dead satellite named Microsat-R. The debris almost hit the International Space Station, and this prompts the question as to the capacity and limits of this technology. Nowadays, the system can be very advanced, being used for military purposes, allowing some to jam communication signals or even to kill military satellites. But this provokes another issue. Most countries are very secretive with this technology, making it brutally hard for more nations to obtain this tech. When obtained though, it can change a country's perspective. The ability to contain and send electromagnetic pulses can allow a nation to have more airspace control, and they can also be used to start or stop cyber attacks for whatever reason. But since this technology is so powerful, it hasn't been put to use in a wartime setting, as most nations have it mainly to show power. India, as one of these nations, has used it for that purpose. During the Cold War, the USSR and the United States both showed off their anti-satellite capabilities, but they used nuclear weapons for such operations, for this would destroy surrounding satellites. So this led to the use of less powerful missiles to perform ASAT functions, allowing for compliance with the Outer Space Treaty, which bans the orbiting of nuclear weapons. So this led to the USSR conducting 7 separate tests, each with funky names, until they created an operational system in 1973. But the USA didn't have as much luck, having only one successful interception in 1985, nor did China, the next nation with this tech, do any better. As recently as 2007, China successfully destroyed a rogue weather satellite named FY1C. Unfortunately, only the USA and Russia have operational infrastructure to launch an anti-satellite weapon from land, sea, and space. India has been very reserved with space and nuclear technologies until recent decades, so this new addition helps them to be perceived as a more powerful nation. Since most of India's space and nuclear programs were developed by themselves, they have large margins to improve or innovate, but this technology shows a new focus for the country: security. Emanating beyond just the surrounding regions, this technology can be used on a global scale, being that it's such a potent military tool. With the recent tests, India may have prompted possible talks about space weaponization, much like the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty, NPT, but India's Prime Minister was quick to defend the project, stating its intent was to defend India's space assets. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you're new to this channel, make sure you hit the thumbs up button, subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you don't miss another video. Also, if you enjoy these videos and want to be a bigger part of our community, make sure you check out our Patreon in the link below. Thank you for watching 1 Minute Facts. This is Gray signing off.